What's up, YouTube? This is Tuba Solo coming at you, and this channel is all about hiking, backpacking, and enjoying the outdoors in Southern California and beyond. If that interests you, consider subscribing. Now let's get to my reasons on why I'm switching from my usual stove system to a Jetboil. Let me tell you a really quick story that's gonna have some relevance to how I got to this point about using a Jetboil. I have a buddy of mine that I grew up with that I backpack with from time to time. You've seen him in some of my videos, and he is by far one of the smartest people that I've ever met. And we were sitting on the side of a mountain one day and we were discussing gear. And to be 100% honest with you, I don't even remember the piece of gear that we were discussing, but I remember trying to kind of explain why I thought this piece of gear was so good, and I had all, I mean, I practically drew a diagram. I mean, it was very convoluted and had very many explanations and what have you. His response to that was basically, man, that sounds like a lot of claptrap. Now, I know the claptrap isn't exactly the correct terminology to use, but it was actually the perfect terminology to use because, yeah, it just seemed like this piece of gear that I was discussing, you know, it had all these different parts going and all these super intricate ways to do the setup or whatever it was that we were discussing, that after a certain point, he just kind of was like, man, that just seems like it's too difficult. And I actually took that to heart and actually implemented that in a lot of the gear choices that I have right now. And what I ended up realizing is that the first filter, when I look at gear amongst, you know, any other filter out there, the most important filter for me has to be ease of use. The reality is that, man, usually I'm pretty tired whenever we get to wherever it is that we're going. And the last thing I need to do is trying to fit, you know, square pegs into round holes, trying to get gear to operate. So I've been basically implementing that in all my gear choices for a couple years now, and it's really done a lot of good. In lieu of taking what's the lightest, I'm taking what's the most functional for me. And yeah, it may weigh a little bit more, but to get that functionality, to me, it's worth the carry. So how do we get to this point with me using the Jetboil Micromo? Now, I've owned the Jetboil. I've had it sitting there in my gear closet for quite a while, and I never really took it out. I did a video on it, which was actually pretty cool. I'll go ahead and link it up in the cards above, where I made some popcorn in it. You know, that's number one. That's really cool that you can make popcorn in a Jetboil if you have the right kind of Jetboil stove. But outside of doing that, I really didn't use the Jetboil very much. And my buddy Matt, who I go backpacking with all the time, you see him in pretty much every single one of my videos, he started bringing his Jetboil. And, you know, I kind of razzed him a little bit at the beginning, and I said, you know, hey, kind of busting out the Jetboil, huh? Yeah, you're really kind of stepping it up in weight there. And when I realized how well, his Jetboil worked and how easy it was, and I'm still sitting there waiting for my stuff to heat up. I got this tippy, you know, I got this tippy pot on my Soto Windmaster. I just kind of stared at it and thought to myself, like, my goodness, the functionality of that is absolutely incredible. I mean, it took him seconds to set up. He poured water into there, and literally a minute and 10 seconds, maybe a minute and 20 seconds, his water was completely boiled. Two cups, rolling boil. And I was utterly blown away at how easily everything worked. Next trip that we took, he once again brought out the Jetboil, and again, I started asking him questions, you know, how does this work? Boy, do you notice the weight difference? Is it really, what do you do when you want to cook in it? How exactly is it working for you? Yeah, on this last trip, man, I finally decided to bust out the Jetboil, and I'm absolutely blown away. So here are the reasons why I'm going to start using the Jetboil more. Well, number one, just plain and simply, is ease of use. It's just a simple thing to use, man. It puts together so quickly. It runs very efficiently. I really can't complain with the performance I've gotten out of the Jetboil. I'm very happy with it. The next reason that I'm going to be using the Jetboil more often is based off of the fact that it's a very efficient stove. Now, I noticed that I came back from this last adventure with significantly more fuel in my canisters. Like, I could literally feel the weight of its efficiency in comparison to my other system. When we're talking about constantly having to buy fuel, right now what I do is I refill my fuel bottles using a valve system where I go from a bigger canister into a smaller canister. I mean, it's gotten to that point where it's so expensive to buy fuel, I'm just buying it in bulk. and then refilling my canisters. But it was incredible how much was left over in comparison to other times when I took different stoves. So yeah, efficiency is definitely one of the reasons why I'm switching to a Jetboil. And the third reason that I'm switching to the Jetboil is that it actually just fits my system. It fits the camping that I'm doing right now. Now, I'll give you an example for that because I know that's kind of a generic statement which may not necessarily make sense. I love using my cup to fill up my water bottles. Now you're probably saying to yourself, like, well, wait a minute, why are you using the cup that you're gonna cook in to fill up your water bottles with dirty water? The thing is that I'm gonna blast this thing with heat, so I'm not necessarily worried about that with filling it up, but just the way that the cup is nice and big, it functions, I can easily dip into the water and fill up my water bottles. There's a lot of benefits to using a Jetboil. From seeing my buddy Matt use it and seeing my buddy Jason from Huck Outdoors, the one that he'd been using for many years. I don't know what the heck took me so long to kind of come around to Jetboil, but really, I'm very happy with the performance and I look forward to taking it on many new adventures that are coming up. And yeah, I think it's gonna work really well for me. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you found it informational or useful, go ahead and hit the thumbs up down below and let me know. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below and make sure to hit the bell for notifications. That way you'll get a notice every single time I post a video. Until next time, take care.